Danny, 27 Swedes have played for the Canucks in the 50-year history of the organization. What is it about Vancouver and Swedish players? I know there's a connection in terms of the game, the city, the environment. Why do you think Swedes have had so much success in Vancouver?
I think it starts from the early Swedes over here. I think they laid the groundwork being good people, I think, and good players. And I think that happens in an organization where you see the same in Detroit, too. I think they had kind of the same thing going. So, yeah, it starts with the early people, and then those years, I think a lot of good people have come to the city.
Do you think a player like Thomas Gredin probably set the bar for a player who could come over and transition his game and be a guy who really understood the game and was a guy people could relate to?
Outstanding player, but like I said, outstanding person too. And then you have Marcus, Matthias, those guys just being great guys.
Who helped you the most in your during your transition here?
Yeah, I mean, Marcus Matthias for sure. We saw Marcus this summer when we got drafted, when we came over that summer too. And they let us grow as people and as players, but we always felt that we could talk to them. That meant a lot.
27 Swedes have played for the Canucks over the 50 years. What is it about? Is it the city? Is it the game? Why have so many Swedish players been able to acclimate to the city and the North American game so well, especially here in Vancouver?
Yeah, I don't know. I think, first of all, I think Vancouver and Canada and Sweden are pretty similar in the, like, just the feel of the people and the city itself is, reminds, I think, a lot of Swedes about Sweden. And so that's one thing. And I think Swedes are fairly loyal people to, or players. When you get drafted and you want to succeed the place where you get drafted, and there's not a lot of Swedes that go ask for trades or want to leave. That's one reason as well. And Thomas Green is a big thing now lately. Yeah. Where he was the one who found us and Alex Edler and a lot of other players. So he's another big reason.
A lot of players have told me it was the Swedish players' ability to understand the game, read the game, probably had the skill level, but acclimate quicker than they thought. A lot of players have told me that. Is that something just kind of ingrained in the Swedish hockey culture of being so ingrained in the game and being able to transfer that here?
Yeah, I think we all were brought up as team players, team first, and it was never about your own abilities. Like to score or win games yourself, it's about the team. So I think when you come over here, it's the same. You have that ingrained in you, and that's you want to help the team and in any way. And I'm sure there's other nationalities are the same, but I think the way we were brought up, you play hockey to be a team player.
Canadian players have said the Swedes are just like us, except for the yelling and screaming. But Danny said, no, we behind closed doors, the Swedes can scream as well as anybody else.
Oh, for sure. That's not. I mean, there's a lot of talk about it, who's winners and who can win the big games and who plays in what way. But deep down, I think we're just hockey players. It doesn't matter where you come from. You want to win as bad if you're Russian or Canadian or Swedish.